respected chief guest for the day, Mr. Jain, respected guest of honor for the day, Mr. Sharma, respected special guest for the day, Mr. Chauhan, and our respected board of directors, Mr. R.K. Sadmani. Most respected my fellow colleagues and respected directors and HODs of institutions. It's a privilege for me to deliver a theme address and welcome address on this particular topic. If I go back on the history of creating this topic for this third conference, I'll go back in 2006 and 7, when by my nature of interest, I started teaching international business and trade to management students. And there was one topic in that particular chapter which always mesmerized me, and that topic was political economy. Now, by word political economy, we understand that we are going to talk about something politics and something economics. But it was not that in international business and trade. It was talking about culture, talking about the democracy, talking about the economics, and talking about the geopolitical situations. So that was the crux of the topic political economy. So when I started teaching political economy at that time, I always get signals, and that was the high time when we were into the globalization and liberalization era. So I was teaching to all management graduates that this is the way of doing business all over the world, and this is how we should adjust ourselves in this trading scenarios. But suddenly, since last 2 to 3 years, that political economy meaning has changed to me. There is a huge change in the world political economy now. Earlier we were talking about globalization, but nowadays at least we don't talk about globalization, if not deglobalization. Although we are heading towards that, that's my personal opinion. Or it's a camouflage that has to be understood. So when we were thinking about this scenario of journey from globalization to deglobalization, we were not clear. We were deliberating among our fellow colleagues, fellow society members and other interested stakeholders. But nobody was there to give a clear opinion whether this is going to end or not. So that gave a new trigger of thought to us that, is it a camouflage? Is it someone hiding on the name of nationalism, deglobalization and globalization, or is it a new reality? We have to understand. There are few signals with which we get vibes of sometimes it's a camouflage. Camouflage means when you hide, in leaves, the army hides under the leaves to cover themselves from the enemy. That's the camouflage. Who is the enemy? We don't know this particular topic, but there is someone who has to take care of that. So when we were deliberating, we were not able to reach to a conclusion whether it's a reality or not. So there were certain instances in last 3 to 4 months when we announced this particular conference. Before announcing this conference, I discussed this thing with our dear friend Mr. Chauhan, who is the state head of Madhya Pradesh CII, that this is something which we are visualizing. He immediately catched the topic. Yes, we should deliberate on this. So I think we got the first signal from CII, that is the industry itself, that there is something to discuss on this particular issue. And then the plethora of news came in last 2 to 3 months, which established that there is something which is going on the name of globalization and deglobalization. I'll go back to the little history, because I have allotted a 10 minutes time. I will definitely restrict myself to 10 minutes because you all are experts and you will deliberate on this for the whole day. If we go back to the history, there was a colonial system, and today morning our dear and respected Mr. Sharma was also talking to me about that Korea issue and the Trump issue. if you go back to the colonial system, if we see that there was a, this was the colony of Japan, you know, South Korea and North Korea, and China gave the way to, you know, between them a truce was there. This I'm talking for 40-50 years back. But at that time, US did a nuclear assassination in North Korea. And there is a legacy in the mind of North Koreans that this is the nuclear thing which has destroyed us. And that is the reason why every person in North Korea, every citizen of North Korea wants to become self-sufficient and self-reliant. There is a phrase there which is very popular, being self-reliant on nuclear capability. Because they are horrified of their history of getting invaded on nuclear things. So today when we see that North Korea has become a threat on nuclear thing and US is compelling North Korea to stop that, that country has to see what has happened in the past. Where are the roots of these things? But now, how they are trying to stop them? On the name of economic sanctions. So in the culture economy, in politics, democracy, religion, one thing has entered, that is business. So now the war instruments have changed. Earlier it was nuclear, now it is economic sanctions. You go and see the data. There is an immediate fight between, the most readable fight is between China and USA regarding their trade wars. We all are aware of that. And I'll give you a small data point which will trigger your thought further. Sharma sir, this is very important here. If I study the data, the total trade deficit between India and China is somewhere about $430 billion. That's the trade deficit. It's almost a half of $1 trillion. And the total GDP of USA is almost $17 trillion. The total trade deficit of USA is around $700 billion, and out of that, more than $400 billion is through China. Now, and the trade deficit is positive towards China. That means they are exporting more and importing less. Earlier in the earlier president regime, Mr. Obama regime, when this president took oath, there was one single point agenda, that was how to give a thought of America first. Now America first cannot be on the geographical limits now because the trend has changed, the world has changed. Now the America first will be to favor the trade deficit in favor of this. So almost $700 billion of trade deficit, total trade deficit with all the countries of the world, out of that is 400 plus is with China. How they are going to resolve it? Nobody can resolve it. So if we say that this is going to be resolved by trade war or by tariffs, I don't believe that. That's my personal opinion. That's not going to happen because it's a huge gap. You will feel interested to know the other data because that's the point which comes to our mind whenever we talk about trade deficits. The trade deficit between India and USA is only $22 billion as compared to $400 plus billion of trade deficit between China and USA. So who will be the beneficiary? If they want to reduce the trade deficit, they cannot do it by producing more in USA. It's not going to happen because we know the thoughts of management, there is comparative advantage, there is competitive advantage, there is natural resource. So they cannot do so on their own. So they have to shift their deficit from country A to country B. And that's how they have pinpointed their name and missile, the economic missile towards Mexico also day before yesterday. Now they are saying that we will give free trade war with, you know, tariff barriers to Mexico also, which is the integral part of their most favored nation region block, that is NAFTA, Canada, Mexico and USA. But still they are, you know, they are giving the guns of trade tariffs to Mexico also. So the disadvantage of one country will become the advantage of other countries. So will it be deglobalization? No. But is this a globalization? Still, it is not globalization also, because you are shifting your trades from one nation to another just because the deficit is more, not on the merits. So when it is not on merits, it is not globalization. And when it is not on merits, it is quite possible it is deglobalization. So something is happening around the world on this trade. Maybe 5 years down the line, again we will sit and have a tea and we'll discuss on tea that we were thinking wrong. This was nothing related to trade and business, this was all related to politics. Because now the things have changed. When you talk about country, you are great. When you don't talk about your country, you are not great. And especially on business fronts, because GDP war has started. Yesterday we saw that our GDP has gone, you know, below 6%. So might be we are more triggered towards increasing the business and trade now. That will be a compulsion on the government. And today morning, I should not say that we are fortunate on the news, but we are, it's unfortunate news. But we are fortunate that that news came in the morning today, that US has withdrawn the GSP, the status from India. That is general system of preference in which you give preference to the countries to enter into duty-free goods, trades and imports and exports. So if the gun is towards China, if the gun is towards Mexico, and today morning it is declared that a little gun is towards India also, so where the trade will go? Because of the competitive and comparative advantage strategy, it's not going to remain only in US. It has to go somewhere. So where it will go and how it will go, that's the deliberation today. And that's the curiosity, at least in my mind, that how the businesses are going to shape in next 5 to 10 years. And why we are deliberating it this into a management institution? Simple. Because we have to teach to our students the latest business trends and how they should think about businesses in the coming times, because they have to work in that particular industry irrespective of globalization and deglobalization. So we thought that it's a good idea that all teachers should come here, listen to the industry experts about their thoughts. If I talk about Mr. C.P. Sharma, they are into international business since ages. He understands the pulse of business. He understands the thoughtfulness of the government. I have been on various forums with Mr. Sharma, and believe me, to when I hear him, it's a pleasure. Why it's a pleasure? Because things come from his gut feeling, what's going to happen. And we have seen many a times that that happens. If I talk about Mr. Jain, I was listening to him somewhere, and I heard this first time, and I was very impressed that he owns a family business. And he was telling that his family sat together for, you know, days to decide about the future course of action of their business, where they will see their business next 5 years, 10 years. That's the professionalism in the family managed business now. So when we were thinking that who will be here to deliberate on this, so these were the two names which came to our mind, that they are the people who will trigger the thought on deglobalization, whether it's a camouflage or a new reality. And Mr. Anirudh Chauhan has always been a great support, because now the relationship between IPER and Mr. Chauhan is like that, that what we think, even when we don't say, he understands. And when this thing happens, and that's the way we should proceed further. And I'm very thankful to Confederation of Indian Industry that they always patronage us on these type of things when we wish to deliberate on these points. There are many good friends of mine who are sitting here. I am not taking the individual names. The reason, I don't know why they have given me 10 minutes on this. I was expecting at least I should get 20 minutes because it was welcome and theme like this. But still, it's a matter of deglobalization now, so things have changed here also. So I limit myself, and you can watch, see your watch. It is exactly 10 minutes. I have completed my thought. I am very thankful to all of you, sir. And it gives butterflies in our stomach because we have to hear you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.